Hi students, we are going to start with one of the very important topic in the type of bonding only. Okay, those two topics we are going to study. First one is 3-center 2-electron bond. Okay, 3-center 2-electron bond and 3-center 4-electron bond. Okay, these are the two topics we are going to cover it now. Okay, so let's start one by one. And after this, there will be very important topic, back bonding. There is very important topic, back bonding. That will be in our next session. Okay. So next session also, don't forget to watch. And lot of application part, back bonding people are studying, but they are not able to understand what is back bonding and how the questions are coming. Okay. So questions are based upon consequences of back bonding are very important. I think already you must have seen my hydrogen bonding consequences lecture. If not seen, kindly go through it. Okay. In the link description box, I will give you the complete link of the chemical bonding. Okay. Chemical bonding playlist I will give you in the description box. You can go through that. Let us start with the first 3-center 2-electron bond. Okay. So this information you may get it in the books, but that much may not be effective, and 4 electron also very less books got that information. Okay. So 3-center 2-electron bond, very most of the places we will get is B2H6. Example for the 3-center 2-electron bond is B2H6. Okay. So let us study in the very basic manner to the advanced level. Okay. So first of all, in this central atom will be boron. So boron atomic number is 5. So 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. Okay. So boron atomic number is 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. So this is what? Ground state. Understood? So 2 boron are there, 6 hydrogen are there. That means there will be 3 hydrogen attached at least with each orbital. But as of the ground state, it is able to form only one bond. Only how many bond? One bond. So ground state is not applicable. Then what it will do? It will move from here to here. Then it will form 2s1 and 2p2. So this is the 2s1 and it is 2p2. Okay. So, but it is the which excited state? It is first excited state. But here each boron is attached to the 4 hydrogens. How many hydrogens? 4 hydrogens. Okay. So what are those 4 hydrogens? And if they wanted to attach with 4 hydrogen, it should be able to, boron should be able to provide 4 orbitals for the hybridization. Okay. So for the first time in the history of the chemistry, empty orbital also included in the hybridization. Okay. So hybridization will be sp3. Okay. Hybridization is going to be sp3, but 4 hybrid orbital also will be forming. But all of them is not going to have the electron. This electron is here, this electron is here, this electron is here, this electron is not there. So here it will not be there. Okay. 4 orbitals, number of hybrid orbital produced will be equal to number of atomic orbitals combined. Therefore, number of atomic orbital will not be same. Sorry, number of all hybrid orbital will not have the electron. 1 will be empty hybrid orbital, 3 will be filled hybrid orbital. Okay. So note down up to here, then like this both boron will undergo and both will form the 4 hybrid orbitals, but among them only 6 will have the electron with them. Okay. Note down this, then we will go further. Okay. Is it clearly visible now? Okay. And have you put your attendance with the like? Please like this session. Okay. So that you can understand and I can be motivated, I can give you in the very very advanced information. Lot of information is there, but only thing for that you give, what you should give, motivation to me, okay, by the likes. And try to write a wonderful comments in the comment section. Okay. So I will pin you so that you can also be famous. Understood? And you can bring somebody to this channel and you can write, sir, my friend is joined your channel because of my reference. Like that, if you write, then I will be taking care of you also. Okay. So let us take B2H6. B2H6. Okay. So how many boron we have? 2 boron we have. Understood? Now out of the 2 boron, we have how many? 6 hydrogens. Okay. So 1, 2, 3. While drawing only, you should be very, very careful, because after drawing you will not understand. Okay. So these are the 4 hydrogens. Then what I will do? 2 hydrogens I will add right at the center. Now each boron have how many hybrid orbital? 4 hybrid orbital. Okay. So this is the 1 hybrid orbital. This is the 2nd hybrid orbital. This is the 3rd hybrid orbital. This is the 4th hybrid orbital. These are the 4 hybrid orbitals. Okay. But clearly I told you, boron having 4 hybrid orbital, but electrons are how many? Only 3. Let us take 1, 2, 3. Okay. Same is the case with this boron also. Same is the case with this boron also. Okay. 1, 2, 3 and 4. These are the 4 hybrid orbitals. Okay. 4 hybrid orbitals are there. Here also same problem. 1, 2, 3. Okay. 3 hybrid orbitals will have electron. This orbital is empty. This orbital also empty. Now hydrogen subshell is S subshell and unhybrid. Okay. So that will have only 1 electron with it. Okay. Same way this hydrogen will also have 1 electron with it. This hydrogen also 1 electron with it. This hydrogen also 1 electron. This hydrogen also 1 electron. This hydrogen also 1 electron. Okay. So this is the complete structure about the B2H6. Understood? Now this is only orbital diagram. Lot of things will be there in the 3-dimensional explanation. So watch till last, and if not liked, kindly like this session. Okay. So what I was telling is, this is 1 boron, this is 1 boron. See, this bond and this bond, do you find something different? Yes. What is the difference? See, because of this bond, how many atoms are clubbed together? 3 atoms are clubbed together. That's why this is called as 3 center. Here out of 3 center, 2 center will be of the boron, 1 center will be of the hydrogen. Understood? But electrons are only 2 electrons. One is provided from this boron, one is provided by the hydrogen. So 3 center, 2 electron, why it is called so, is it understood? Do you find some more bonds like that? Very nice observation. This is the 3rd bond you will find. Understood? So this is also 3 center, this is also 3 center. So, and anywhere else? No. Only 2 3 center 2 electron bonds. This is a common bond. 2 electron 2 center. Okay. Normally what we see in other places, they are 2 center 2 electron. 2 boron, 1 boron and 1 hydrogen are center, 2 electrons. Okay. So 2 center 2 electron bond. These, like this, how many you can find? 1, 2, 3 and 4. So all 4 are 3, 2 center 2 electron. That means as a whole, B2H6. B2H6 contains how many? 2, 3 center 2 electron bond, 4, 2 center 2 electron bond. So number of bonds are how many total? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Now, this, after this, what happens? This will change its shape to like this. Boron, boron, hydrogen. Okay. It just looks like a banana. That's why this 3 center 2 electron is also called as a banana bond. What it is called as? Banana bond. Okay. Note down it carefully. Note down fast. So this is about the banana bond. Don't forget to note down this. Very fast. Note down. Okay. Noted. Now let us see about the banana bond. After the banana bond, how to draw it in the bond line diagram. This is orbital diagram. Okay. Now bond line diagram and three-dimensional view. Okay. So three-dimensional view will be like this. Boron, boron, and two hydrogens. These normal bond. This lines are represents the normal bond. This line represent the normal bond. Okay. So they all lie in one plane. They all lie in one plane. Understood? And one hydrogen. This is dot. Okay. This is what broken line. This is dotted line. Understood? So this is the dotted line. If this is the plane, above this is hydrogen, and below this is another hydrogen. Okay. Below is this another hydrogen. Is it understood? So this is B2H6. What is this? B2H6. So this called as a bridge hydrogen. What it is called as? Bridged hydrogen. Okay. So these are normal hydrogen lies on the plane. Understood? So how many bridge hydrogens are there? Two bridge hydrogens are there, and four hydrogens are coplanar. What they are called as? Coplanar. Okay. Now question will be there. Nowadays the trend is of the integer questions. Okay. Integer question, maximum number of atoms coplanar. Okay. Coplanar are. Okay, tell me what is the answer. Maximum number of atoms coplanar. Coplanar means one same plane it should be available. How many atoms are in one plane? Okay, very good. Answer is what? 6. What are those? 2 boron and 4 hydrogen. Out of this 6, there will be 2 boron and 4 hydrogens are one plane. Okay, maximum number of atoms coplanar are. Okay, now question will be minimum number of atoms coplanar. Okay, this is what most of the students are doing mistake. People are writing 2. No, answer is 4. See, this is a vertical plane. Okay, this boron, like this also it is there, like this also it is there. This is the common part. So 2 boron and 2 hydrogens. Answer is what? 4. Okay. Out of 4, 2 are boron, 2 are hydrogens. Are you able to note down this? Okay, note down it very carefully. Note down how you will note down? You will note down very carefully. This is the plane. Broken line represents plane, and dotted line represents what they will represent? Dotted line. Dotted line will be above and below. That is a hydrogen banana bond. And one more mistake most of the people are doing. Number of banana bonds. Okay, have you noted this? Very good. So there is one more question. What is that number of banana bonds? This was the most wrongly attempted question. Okay. Number of banana bonds. Number of banana bonds is equal to, tell me, who will tell me the correct answer? Number of banana bonds, all are writing 4, but is 2, because this combinedly called as one banana bond. This combinedly called as one banana bond. So people will count like this and will write 4. So number of banana bonds are how many? Only 2. These are the some integer type questions. Okay. Normal hybridization of the boron will be sp3. Okay. So like that in simple questions will be there. This is about the 3 center 2 electron bond. Okay. Now what I told you, I will explain about the 3 center 4 electron bond. Have you drawn this? Let us see about the 3 center 4 electron bond. Okay. Don't skip this video. Watch till the last, because important things will be discussed at the last. Okay. So let us see about the 3 center 4 electron bond. Okay. 3 center 4 electron bond. 3 center, what I told you, there will be how many? Very good. Three atoms. Electrons will be how many? Very good. Four electrons. Okay. Now let us say about the BCl3. Okay. So after this there will be back bonding. Okay. There will be what bonding? Back bonding. So before that what I will take? I will take an example of AlCl3. Okay. So because BCl3 will understand better way. That is also example for here. But you will understand in better way in the after back bonding. Okay, AlCl3. So actually if you take the aluminium here, okay, aluminium, it will be last electronic configuration will be 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2 and 3p1. Okay, so last it is having how many electrons? 3 electrons. So what will be the hybridization? sp2 hybridization. So what should be the triangular planar? Okay, so this is the triangular planar. This is what triangular planar. I am not drawing it exactly. See, 3 electrons from aluminium and 3 electrons are provided from the chlorine. Okay, now after this still it is not able to form. I will draw it completely here. 3s2 3p1 and after this excitation it will be 3s1 3p2. Okay, so this is the 3s1 and this is what 3p2 and 3d will be empty. What will be empty? 3d will be empty. Is it understood? Now from here to here hybridization? No. Okay, see, hybrid orbital, this will be the empty orbital. P orbital is empty or not? Okay, so that empty orbital will be utilized over here. Okay. This is one more AlCl3. Okay, this is another AlCl3. Now the electron rich atoms are chlorine, electron deficient atoms are aluminium, because after completely trying also they are not able to complete their octate. Even after they are trying their hard level, okay, but they are not able to complete their octate. So this is the AlCl3. Now you concentrate here. How many centers? 3 centers. Okay, but electrons are how many? 1, 2, 3, 4. So this bond is called as a 3 center 4 electron bond. Same way here also, 3 center 4 electron bonds. Okay, so AlCl3 will undergo dimerization to form Al2Cl6. Okay, so that now every aluminium when you compare there will be octate formed. 3 to the 6 electron from the normal covalent bond and 1 coordinate covalent bond, that is 3 center 2 electron bond, will result in its octate. Okay, Al2Cl6. Is that clear to you? Note down this. Okay, this is about the, here also hybridization is sp3 only, understood? Sorry, sp2 only, but the empty orbital will accept the electron from the lone pair of the chlorine. Okay, so this is about the 3 center 4 electron bond. I hope you like this session till now. If not like this and share it to your friends, call them and take your name. Sir, he is that subscriber who I am referred and he is on our channel regularly watching this. See you. Bye bye.